people we spoke with today are livid with Congress. They say lawmakers are responsible for yesterday's 500-point drop in the Dow. Kathleen O'Toole is in the newsroom, and there's a lot of frustration, Kathleen.
You got it. There's a new poll just out today that says 82% of Americans disapprove of the way Congress is acting, and that was before all the red ink started flowing on Wall Street.
Bert Houston's teeing off with his buddy, but he's teed off at Congress.
Not happy with him at all.
Tell me why you're not happy with him.
I think you ought to stop on that one.
The Dow's dive has this threesome frustrated and frightened.
Pretty disappointed. They delayed the inevitable, and now everybody's having to pay the price.
Everyone's 401k is taking a dump and everything, and it's, you know, it's scary.
People are used to the ups and downs of the stock market, but this time, they're really steamed. They think Congress is acting like kids. In fact, a new poll out found that 3/4 of Americans think that Congress has tarnished our image overseas.
America does not like Congress. And it hasn't for a while, but it really doesn't like Congress now.
Northwood University American Government Professor Tim Gilbert says Congress, between a fairly liberal Senate and Tea Partiers trying to hold true to pledges, is particularly polarized now, and this brings tons of uncertainty to our markets.
We're seeing this clash, and it is polarizing. It's not going to be resolved until the next election, if even then, depending on how much of the anger is voiced at the polls.
Joe Ralley knows duffs are inevitable, but he and a majority of Americans are now expecting a lot more of Congress.
I hate to say that some priorities are out of order, but I feel priorities out of order. I think we need to put our priorities straight and get the economy back.
So what does Congress do out there? Well, we got a lot of suggestions, as you can imagine, Victor. And it's interesting because even in our golfing group, there were the polarizing views once again. One of the golfers wanted increased spending to spur on job growth. The other says, government, get out of our lives, Victor.
Okay, so here's a question. Is it just with Congress this discussed, or does it stretch across to the executive branch?
Au contraire, yes, exactly. We visited the cell phone waiting lot at the airport today to kind of get a finger on the pulse of what people were saying. And there was one woman and more than one who actually wanted to take great aim at the president. They said the president is responsible for a lot of the uncertainties in our markets. We're live in the newsroom. Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.